Liberty British Aluminium and Cymec, both members of the GFG Alliance, bought the smelting operation at Lochaber because they could see a positive future built on Scotland's century of experience making aluminium. When the Lochaber smelter was taking shape in the 1920s, it was to be the jewel in the crown of British Aluminium's Scottish operations, larger than all the others. Britain was then an imperial power, active in the world's economy. In 1930, newly opened Lochaber received a visit by the Duke of York. It was hailed as a symbol of the future. Back in 1895, Lord Kelvin, the Scottish scientist, had spoken of an industrial revival across the Highlands, based on aluminium. During World War II, Lochaber played a key role in the war effort, earning it a visit by the Luftwaffe. This is one of their bombs. It failed to explode. Lochaber remained profitable. Round-the-clock production, almost essential for any smelter, was made possible by a huge hydroelectric operation built across 90 miles of the Highlands, involving lochs connected by tunnels and fed by managed watercourses. There were over 2,000 men involved in building this system, working in all weathers, often in difficult conditions.
It's a phenomenal task when you think 1929 is when the power station opened, so the construction started 1925, 1926. For these guys to have the vision to look how they were going to link these water bodies together, and then the challenge of actually getting people onto site, building the dams the size that we have, building the 24 kilometres of tunnel. They didn't have any computers, they didn't have GPS. It was all done manual calculations, slide rules. It is an incredible feat of engineering. It would be a challenge today to do it, but to think when they done it back in those days, you've got to take your hat off to these individuals.
The graceful outlines of the 1930s Lochaber power station, where water becomes energy, are testament to the great age of industrial design. The buildings largely unchanged, but the turbines have been updated. In the last 2 years, new biomass generators have been installed as a backup supply during periods of low rainfall. Manufacturing requires alumina, a powder processed from bauxite, which is brought to the site by rail. Inside the two pot room buildings, clearly visible from space, the rows of pots are filled and drained as the metal is made. The process is heavily protected and securely enclosed, as the alumina is turned into molten aluminium by electrolysis. In these cells, the powdered alumina is first dissolved into an acidic chemical bath. Large amounts of electricity are passed through anodes into the mixture, causing pure aluminium to separate and sink to the bottom of the cell. The anodes are themselves largely destroyed by the reaction. They are replaced on a regular basis with spent material prepared for recycling. New anodes are delivered to the site and attached by casting. All emissions, including carbon dioxide, are monitored and controlled. The molten aluminium is poured into special vehicles and transferred to the casting room. Casting is the process of turning the molten primary metal into pans or larger ingots. In the furnace, alloys are added to the mix to give the metal the specific qualities required, dependent on the end use planned. All aluminium is strong, light, and can be endlessly recycled. It never rusts. The workforce at Lochaber is skilled and committed.
I think people see us as a good employer, so it encourages loyalty. I think most people like working here. It's a great location, isn't it? I mean, you can't ask for a nicer place to work. But I think also what we're doing is we're targeting people at young age. We're heavily dependent on our maintenance front from the apprenticeship scheme that we have here. And people see that as an opportunity to develop their skills and get into good jobs.
The operation at Lochaber is actually small in global terms, with a maximum output capacity dwarfed by operations elsewhere in the world. But Liberty plans to build a new auto components factory alongside the smelter, allowing it to increase the value of the aluminium by turning it into wheels.
Our advantage here is that we're going to turn molten metal into an end product, which doesn't happen anywhere else that I'm aware of. Usually what happens is the new metal that we make gets cast into an ingot, it gets shipped off to a third party who'll melt it or heat it to soften it up and turn it into another product. From an environmental perspective, what we're doing here is hugely important because we're going to take away all that centrepiece which currently happens at the moment, so it's hugely significant.
After more than a century of production, Lochaber looks set to continue manufacturing well into the future.